Hey everybody, out in the pits here at the NHRA, looking for cool cars, check out this Maverick. Not only is it a Maverick, think about Maverick, right? But it's a military Maverick. United States Air Force, Fred Elsass, breaking out this cool car. Fred, I love your car, tell us about it.
It's a 1974 Maverick, and when we bought it, it was a straight Maverick, but we converted it to the Grabber by putting all the decals on it.
The Maverick is like the less appreciated Ford performance car in my mind. Everybody talks about Mustangs all the time, but there is a diehard bunch for Mavericks out there. Tell us why you picked the Maverick to race.
Well, it's interesting. I had this is the second Ford I've had since 1960. I primarily was a General Motors racer, a Chevrolet. I had a Malibu that was beautiful. And a fella called me from Houston and said, I want your Malibu, I got a Maverick. I said, why not?
Swapped them?
Right, swapped it out. And it's been a money pit ever since.
The GM guys are like, yeah, and the Ford guys are like, yeah.
The bad thing about, or the different thing about Maverick is trying to find parts. Because it's very, very difficult. The aftermarket has tons of stuff for Chevrolet. All the GM products, but this version, it's like it's very difficult to find parts for it.
Well, it's a great looking car, and I can see, and obviously I see your hat, and I can tell you are retired United States military, of course the Air Force, big in the National Hot Rod Association. Maverick, although they were naval aviators, still very popular in the movie. Thank you for your service, and I love how you're showcasing it on your car.
Well, it was probably the smartest thing I ever did until I married my bride. Now it's number two. I'm very proud of the military. I was one of those academic failures in high school. Graduated with a stellar 1.9 GPA. I concentrated on extracurricular. If it was academic, I wasn't interested. The best sleeping pill I ever found was a book in study hall. And I joined the Air Force in 1962 and immediately went through 16 weeks of aircraft maintenance school and graduated with a 91 average. So it wasn't me, it was the way I was being taught. And the Air Force has been really good for me. 27 years, didn't regret a moment of it. It was fantastic.
And still representing, and I think that story that you just shared is the story for so many people out there. It's not you, it's you need something different and we'll figure it out. I love that you're showcasing that on your car and I would love to see under the hood. Can we do that?
You got it.
Show us, Fred. How cool is that? And a great lesson. And we talk about it all the time here at the NHRA, and the United States Air Force is a partner. You can work on all kinds of great technology in the Air Force. But I like this technology, Fred. Tell us about this engine.
That is a 302 cubic inch. It has a two-barrel carburetor, factory rated 140 horsepower. We have made almost 200 horsepower at the rear wheels with it. It's been blueprinted, stock eliminator. In fact, we've gone through four teardowns for records since I've had it, and three have been successful, and one I got bounced for 9/1000ths of an inch, not enough head gasket.
9/1000. Give him a break, right?
I set my first national record in 1973, and I was disqualified for 3/1000ths, too much camshaft. So on stock eliminator, we are in certification for approximately 4 hours. From the time we have to take the carburetor, intake manifold, cylinder head, they measure everything that can be measured, including the wheelbase of the car. Of course, you have to make two runs and you have to weigh the car, and the car has a minimal weight that it has to meet, and also they check fuel on the two runs.
Is this car the current record holder in its category or other categories?
This car is the current record holder in T and U stock automatic. And in August, we're going to try to set the R stock national record. And the in stock eliminator, the class is determined horsepower to weight. and it's the factory shipping weight and whatever the horsepower rating is, whether it's the factory rating or the rating that NHRA gives it. Now, this engine here, 140 horsepower from the factory, and NHRA has factored it to 153. So when you divide the horsepower into the shipping weight of the car, that's how you come up with the class. Our stock is 18 pounds per horse, T is 19, and U is 20. So in fact, I've got the weights on the side of the car, the minimums that it has to be legal.
Amazing. Can we see you in the cockpit of your race car?
Sure, sure.
All right.
No problem.
Now, I know a lot of people probably wondering, like, man, 302 has got a lot of potential, the factory rating 140 horsepower, but you got to think about when this car rolled off the factory line. There was a lot going on in the world related to fuel, and they were trying to become economical and all that, but we know that 302's got a lot of potential.
Yes, and right now we're probably as close as you can be to the potential it could have without cheating, and that's not going to happen.
Of course not. Meaning you have to retain like factory cam lift, which was not a lot.
You retain the stock lift, but you can run as much duration in the camshaft that you can get in the engine.
Tell us about making a run in this record holder.
Okay, it's just a matter of setting it up. I try to run, pull to the starting line at about 130 degrees engine water temperature, and check oil pressure. And I've got the switches here. I got one switch for the water pump and the fan. I've got another one for the fuel pump. I got a third one, which is the power switch. And then I've got the starter button. And it's a fully automatic. It's a C4 automatic transmission, three-speed, high stall converter. And I leave the line at probably about 2,000 RPM, and it immediately flashes to about 4,000, and two shifts later, I'm on my way to the finish line.
And best ET and speed to this point?
Best ET was a 1340 at 98 mile an hour, and the factory index for U is 1385. So, in fact, we've qualified at a race in St. Louis. There was 150 cars, and we qualified number 5 out of 150. And you can see here on the back window is where the minimum weights are that the car has to run for RT and U stock automatic.
Amazing. I love that you've got that listed there. Can we hear it run, Fred?
Sure.
Fire it up. Here we go. United States Air Force. How about that? That's what a record holder and stock eliminator sounds like. Fred, United States Air Force veteran. That's for all you veterans out there. Fred, thank you so much. You're a perfect example of it. Thank you for sharing your car with us.
My pleasure.
And that is why you come out into the pits here at the NHRA.